Hi everyone. Today we will see about principle and working of torque tube and Hotchkiss type propeller shafts, and also we will discuss about what is universal joint and what is the purpose of universal joint and what are the different types of universal joint. These topics we will discuss in this class. In coming to yesterday's class, we will see about the what is the principle and working of the propeller shaft. So in yesterday we will see about the what is the principle of propeller shaft and what are the functions of propeller shaft and what are the different components assembled in the propeller shaft, what is the main purpose of propeller shaft, and what are the advantages applications of these propeller shaft. These topics we are discussed in yesterday's class. Today we will see about the what are the different types of propeller shafts. So in these propeller shafts we have two different types. It is torque tube propeller shaft and a Hotchkiss type propeller shaft. These are the two different types of propeller shafts used in the automobile vehicles. And also we will discuss about the universal joint. Coming to the topic, first of all, what is propeller shaft? The propeller shaft is connecting the drive from the gearbox to final drive. Hence, it is also called as the driving shaft. If the propeller shaft is connected through the driving shaft, that driving shaft, it is a engine output shaft. That engine output shaft is connected through the propeller shaft at one end, and another end of the propeller shaft is connected through the differential shaft. That is another end of the propeller shaft. So that driving shaft of the propeller shaft is connected through the one end, it is output shaft of the engine, and it is the group of parts connecting the transmission with the drive wheels. It consists of the propeller shaft. It is also called as the drive shaft and universal joints, constant velocity joints and slip joints. By this propeller shaft we will connect the different joints are used. These joints, it is what type of different joints used in automobile vehicles? It is universal joints or slip joints or constant velocity joints. These are the different types of joints used to fix the propeller shaft and engine transmission shafts. By using these joints, the output engine shaft and the propeller shaft should be connected with these joints only. Okay, so based upon our working operation, based upon the vehicles, the joints should be different. Suppose we can see the slip joint. These slip joints are used at four wheel drive mechanism or rear wheel drive mechanism. The propeller shaft should be very high length. We can use the slip joint. Okay, basically we will use the universal joints in all automobile vehicles. So based upon the length of the propeller shaft, the length should be increased, we can use the slip joints. Okay, so these are the different types of joints are also used in the connection of propeller shaft with automobile vehicle engine with the differential. What is the function of this propeller shaft? This propeller shaft take power from the gearbox output shaft without making any change in power. It transmits the same to the input pinion of the differential unit, from where power is transmitted to the drive wheels through rear axle. So the power should be developed in engine. So the power is transmitted through various operations, various components through the axles. That is, in automobile vehicles, we have front axles, rear axles. In that front axles, there are different suspension systems also. And front axle, rear axle, and also four wheel drive axles. So these are the different types of axles based in the automobile vehicles. What is the main thing is the power should be developed in engine. So that power should be transmitted at one shaft to the another shaft by using one place to another place by using this propeller shaft. So this propeller shaft is connected through the engine output shaft. That engine output shaft, it is clutch shaft. Okay, so the engine output shaft is clutch shaft, that is a driving shaft of the propeller. So that that is also known as, the propeller shaft is also known as driving shaft. So that is connected at one end of the propeller shaft in engine output shaft by using this universal joint. And next one, another end of the propeller shaft is connected to the differential. So in that differential, what type of joints we are used is universal joint. If the joint is used, engine output shaft and differential shaft, we are using only same joint, that is universal joint. Based upon the vehicle, the joint should be changed. Okay, so the output should be same as transferred by this propeller shaft. How much amount of output should be developed on this engine, same without changing any output values, same gradient, same amount of output should be transmitted through this propeller shaft at the rear axle drive. So that rear axle drive, we have a differential to transmit the power. So that is the function of the propeller shaft. And to accommodate the change in line and the level between gearbox output shaft and the differential input pinion shaft. So to accommodate the change in level, so the change in level between the output gearbox output shaft and the differential input shaft, so that has a change in line, because the length should be increased, the propeller shaft length should be increased. Some slip joints are also used to connect this propeller shaft. So these are the functions of the propeller shaft. Coming to today's topic, what are the different types of propeller shafts used in the automobile vehicles? Mainly, there are two types of propeller shafts used in the automobile vehicle. One is torque type propeller shaft and another one is Hotchkiss type propeller shaft. What is meant by torque tube type propeller shaft and another one is Hotchkiss type propeller shaft? You can see torque tube type propeller shaft. A torque tube is a large diameter tube fastened securely to the rear axle housing, completely enclosing the propeller shaft in torque drive. The propeller shaft is enclosed in a hollow tube. The torque tube are fitted into a spherical ball and socket surrounding one universal joint at a transmission end. So that is the torque tube propeller shaft. What he told is, a torque tube is a large diameter tube. So the torque tube, what type of propeller shaft we are taken in this automobile vehicles, there are two types. One is torque tube and Hotchkiss type. This torque tube type, it has a large diameter tube. What he told is a large diameter tube and fastened securely to the rear axle housing. And the fastened securely of the rear axle housing. So how much amount of power should be developed on the engine? That power should be transmitted within seconds by using this propeller shaft. The output should be transmitted. Okay, so the diameter tube should be fastened securely to the rear axle housing and completely enclosing the propeller shaft. And this propeller shaft, it is enclosing with each other, completely enclosure. What he told is completely enclosure of this propeller shaft. In torque drive, the propeller shaft is enclosed in a hollow tube. So this propeller shaft, this torque tube propeller shaft, it is enclosed in a hollow tube. What it is? It is enclosed in a hollow tube. And the torque tube are fitted into a spherical ball and a socket surrounding our universal joint at transmission end. this torque tube propeller shaft, it is connected with a spherical ball and socket surrounding at the one end of the universal joint in the transmission end. So the power should be transmitted at the engine to the differential by the connection of this propeller shaft. In this torque tube propeller shaft, the connection is connects with a spherical ball with socket, a spherical ball with socket, and then the output of the engine shaft, it is connected with the spherical with a socket, spherical ball with socket. That type of universal joint he is using to he is used to fit this propeller shaft one end and engine output shaft. Okay, you can see this diagram. So in this torque tube propeller shaft, it is the torque tube propeller shaft, it is the propeller shaft, it is the propeller shaft, it is the propeller it is the propeller shaft. So we are using the in this propeller shaft, in the torque tube propeller shaft, a hollow tube is covered with the propeller shaft. All the propeller shaft should be, all surrounding should be connected with covered with a hollow tube. It is the above particle of the propeller shaft is a hollow tube. Okay, it is covered with propeller shaft. In this propeller shaft, one end is connected through the engine output shaft. Engine output shaft, it is the engine. Okay, it is the engine, and it is the engine output shaft. It is connected through the one end of the propeller shaft by using a spherical ball and a socket type universal joint is used to fix this one end of the propeller shaft. And another end of the propeller shaft is connected through the rear axle of the differential. Another end of the propeller shaft is connected through the rear axle. It is the front axle. There is a front axle. In this front axle, these are the front wheels. These are the front wheels. By another end of the propeller shaft is connected through the rear axle. In this rear axle, it is the axle and it is connected through the wheels. These rear axles have wheels. So by using a universal joint, it is connected through the differential input shaft. So the another end of the propeller shaft and the differential input shaft is connected by the universal joint. So torque tube bolted to axial housing. So the torque tube is bolted. So another end of the propeller shaft is fitted with the bolted to the axial housing, torque tube bolted axial housing. It is the axial housing. So the axial housing, it is fitted with the another side of the propeller shaft is bolted operation. By this operation, the power should be transmitted the engine output shaft to the differential input shaft. Whenever the engine output shaft rotates, automatically the propeller shaft is also rotates. The propeller shaft also rotates. Then in this direction, there is a mechanism is placed in between the differential. The wheel should be moving. The wheel should be moving at forward and reverse direction of this automobile vehicle. Okay, so that is the total working of the torque tube type propeller shaft. You can see what is the connection of this torque tube type and how to connect automobile vehicles by using this torque tube drive is the gearbox is placed in the one place of the automobile vehicle. So it is the gearbox. In this gearbox, so it is the gearbox transmission shaft, that is the output shaft of the gearbox. So in this we have covered with one cup. One cup. So in that cup, it is placing a universal joint. It is placing a universal joint. Based upon that universal joint is connected to the engine output shaft. Okay. So it is the torque tube type propeller shaft. Torque tube type propeller shaft. So that torque tube type propeller shaft, another end is connected through the universal joint of the rear axle differential input shaft. So the differential input shaft of the rear axle is connected through the universal joint of torque tube type. Okay, so by this the wheels suspension, we are placing a leaf spring type. It is placing through connection of frame and the differential rear axle of the differential is connected in the automobile vehicle. Based upon the different loads are acting on this automobile vehicle, so suspension should be getting a high amount of suspension getting and a low amount of suspensions getting. So that load should be bear on these wheels. We can place this type of suspension type springs on this automobile vehicle. Okay, so in further classes we will detail explanation see about the this type of suspension systems we will see later. So today in this class you can see the torque tube drive. So it is the connection of the torque tube drive in the engine output shaft to the differential input shaft, that is rear axle drive, in the torque tube drive system. In torque tube drive, the propeller shaft is enclosed in a hollow tube. So in that torque tube shaft, the propeller shaft is enclosed in a hollow tube, and the tube is rigidly bolted to the differential housing. At one end is fastened, at the other end is to be transmission through the somewhat flexible joint that is called universal joint. This situated in a spherical cup is fixed to that frame. So the tube is rigidly bolted on the differential housing. At one end is fastened, at the other end is transmitted through the somewhat of the flexible joint. So that is called universal joint. That is called universal joint. So these two are connected with the output shaft, and differential input shaft is connected through the universal joint. Okay, this universal joint is connected through the cup. So the other end to be transmitted through a somewhat flexible joint situated in a spherical cup fixed to the frame. So the spherical cup, it is the spherical cup is fixed to the frame with the connection of universal joint in the automobile vehicle. Okay. The torque reaction, the driving thrust are taken up by the torque tube. So the torque reaction, so the engine power should be developed. The engine power is transmitted into the torque system by using the transmission system. So the how much amount of power should be developed in the engine, the torque is transferred through the different transmission system. By this transmission system, the torque is developed. That torque should be transmitted through the torque tube in the rear axle of the automobile vehicle. Okay, so that is the main purpose of the torque tube in the automobile vehicle. When the vehicle comes across a bump or shocks, the center line of the bevel pinion shaft will not be shift and always passes through the center of spherical cup. When the vehicle comes across a bump or shocks, so the vehicle wheels should be contact with any amount of loads or any bumps or shocks, the center line of the bevel pinion shaft. So it is the center line of the bevel pinion shaft. So the center position of the bevel pinion shaft will not be shift and always passes through the center of the spherical cup. So that's why he is placing a spherical cup through connection of frame by this joint. Okay, so by these joints, is bear the any amount of loads are acting on the automobile vehicles at any amount of shocks or vibrations acting on this joint, it is very reliable and it is very high strength getting on this joint. Hence, only universal joint is required at front end and no universal joint at the rear end. So in some of the cases, in some of the vehicles, only one universal joint is required at front end. Only the front end operation, one end of the propeller shaft is connected only universal joint. At another end of the propeller shaft is not connected the universal joint. The other joints are connected, or any bolting systems are used to connect the other end of the propeller shaft. The tube incorporates bearing which support the propeller shaft. So the tube incorporates bearing which support the propeller shaft. It is usually located between the gearbox and the propeller shaft. So the location of the gearbox and the transmission should be transferred through this propeller shaft. So how much amount of torque should be developed on the transmission system of the automobile vehicle engine, that torque should be transmission through the propeller shaft by using this propeller shaft. No sliding joint is required in the propeller shaft. So there is no sliding joint. There is no sliding motion of this propeller shaft. In this drive, the leaf springs takes only one side thrust besides supporting weight of the body. So the leaf springs are used to bear the different loads are acting on the automobile vehicle or different suspension systems. That's why he is using leaf spring types. So there are using different types of suspension systems in automobile vehicles. In further classes, we will discuss about these suspension systems. And next one, next type of propeller shaft, it is Hotchkiss drive type propeller shaft. In this Hotchkiss drive propeller shaft, you can see what type of joints is used. So in this Hotchkiss drive propeller shaft, he is used the propeller shaft at two ends are connected with universal joint, but the torque tube drive system, only one end is connected with universal joint and another end is under first end of the propeller shaft is connected through the one cup. That cup is fixed with the frame. Okay, so that is the torque tube drive, and the Hotchkiss drive is both ends of the propeller shaft is connected with the universal joint. So that is the main difference between the torque tube type propeller shaft and Hotchkiss type drive propeller shaft. So as usual, the overall concept of the torque tube drive and a Hotchkiss drive is same. Only the universal joints are the one is the difference in the Hotchkiss drive and a torque tube drive propeller shaft. So in this Hotchkiss drive, the Hotchkiss drive is simplest and most popular form of rear axle suspension. So this Hotchkiss drive is the simple and most popular form of rear axle suspension. So in automobile vehicle system, the suspension is the torque should be transmitted at a rear axles. This type of propeller shafts are used in more vehicles because of the engine should be placed in a rear position. Sorry, front end position. The power should be transmitted through rear wheels. So this type of propeller shaft are used to transfer the torque. In Hotchkiss drive, combines the springing and positioning or locating of the rear axle. This Hotchkiss drive combines the springing and positioning and locating the rear axle. It uses a rigid axle with a leaf spring mounted at its extremes as far apart as possible on the rear axle. The Hotchkiss drive consists of a leaf spring and a propeller shaft with two universal joint and one sliding joint. So in this rear axle torque transmission system, this type of Hotchkiss drive propeller shafts are used. So the both ends of the propeller shafts are connected through the universal joint, and one slip joint is also used in this Hotchkiss drive type propeller shaft. The front end of the leaf spring is pivoted in pin of bracket, which is bolted to the vehicle frame. The front end of the leaf spring, you can see the suspension system. You can see the suspension system of the Hotchkiss drive propeller shaft. So the front end of the propeller shaft, the front end, it is the front end of the leaf spring. It is the front end of the leaf spring. It is connected through the frame by using the bolted, by the help of bolted, it is fitted to the frame. Okay, it is fitted to the frame. While rear end of the leaf spring is supported in swinging shackle with anti-friction bush material. So the rear end of the leaf spring is the rear end of the leaf spring. The rear end of the leaf spring is connected through the shackle with the help of with the connection of frame. So the rear end of the leaf spring is also connected with the frame, and it has a connection with leaf spring and the frame. It is shackle. So the shackle connection is placed in the another end of the rear end of the leaf spring. The spring takes weight of the body, torque reaction and driving thrust. So this leaf spring takes the weight of the body, overall weight of the body, and torque reaction and driving thrusts on the leaf spring. This the driving and braking torques are absorbed through the front half of the rear leaf spring, shown by the dotted line. The driving and braking torques are absorbed through the front half of the rear leaf spring. So when the driver should run the vehicle on roads, any type of loads are acting, bumps are getting, and fluctuations are any type of damping forces are getting this leaf spring to take that suspension, the vehicle should run smoothly on the road. During driving and braking, the bevel pinion changes the position, so the length and angle of propeller shaft changes, which will be adjusted by the universal joint and sliding joints. During the driving and braking, the bevel pinion changes the position. So driving and braking system, in some other automobile vehicles, the position of the pinion should be changed when the length and angle of the propeller shaft is also changed. So this type of propeller shaft, we should connect the adjusted by the universal joint and sliding joints of the propeller shaft. Therefore, if only one universal joint is at front end, and then the propeller shaft may bend or damage. So that is connection of the propeller shaft in the automobile vehicle. If only one universal joint is at the front end, then the propeller shaft may be bend or damage. So this type of joint is used at a high length of the propeller shaft. So the front end of the propeller shaft should be bent or damaged. To avoid this, another universal joint is provided at the rear end. So in this Hotchkiss drive, it is the main purpose of Hotchkiss drive propeller shafts are used in the automobile vehicles. So to avoid this problem, another universal joint is also provided in the rear end of the propeller shaft. Okay. So the rear end of the vehicle, the another end of the propeller shaft is also placing a universal joint. When the vehicle comes across a bump or shocks, the rear axle moves up and down, and it has to move in a circular with front springs supported at the frame as center. When the vehicle comes across a bump or shocks, so the vehicle is running on a road, there is a bump or shocks getting on that vehicle, the rear axle moves up and down. So the rear axle should be moves at the direction of up and down, and it has to move in a circle
with front spring supported at the frame as the center. During this movement of rear axle, the length of the propeller shaft changes, which will be adjusted by the sliding shaft, sliding joint.
So these shocks and this bump should be avoided. The sliding joint is also placed in the Hotchkiss drive propeller shaft. So that is the purpose of sliding joint is placed in the propeller shaft. So these are the two different types of propeller shafts used in the automobile vehicles. And next one, universal joint. A universal joint allows driving torque to be carried through two shafts that are at an angle with each other. So this universal joint, this universal joint is connects the engine output shaft and one end of the propeller shaft. By this joint, the torque should be transmitted perfectly at the different axles of the automobile vehicle. A simple universal joint consists of a Y-shaped yoke, one on the driving shaft and other on the driven shaft. So a simple universal joint. So there are different types of universal joints. In the different types of universal joints, a simple two Y-shaped yoke, one end of the driving shaft and another end of the driven shaft is connected this universal joint. The four arms of spider are assembled in needle bearings in the two yokes. So the four arms and the spider are assembled with a bearing in the two yokes. The driving shaft and yoke force the spider to rotate. The other two trunnions of the spider then cause of the driven yoke to rotate. When the two shafts are at an angle with each other, the needle bearings permit the yokes to swing around the trunnions with each revolution. You can see this diagram. There is a spider yoke. It is the yoke. Okay. So you can see that yoke, there is a Y-shaped yoke. I am taking Y-shaped yoke with a smooth running operation. With the torque should be transferred at very smooth operation by using Y-shaped torque. That is the one end of the yoke is connected through the driving shaft and another end of the yoke is connected through the driven shaft. Okay. So it is the engine output shaft. This engine output shaft is also known as driving shaft. It is driving shaft because the engine output shaft is connected through this shaft. That's why it is called driving shaft. And I am placing a yoke in the driving shaft. And the spider, by the using of spider, the driven shaft is also connected through this yoke. The driven shaft is also connected this yoke with the driving shaft. So it is driven shaft. It is driven shaft. It is driven shaft. This driven shaft, Another one end is connected with yoke and another end is connected through the differential input shaft. Differential input shaft. And the driven shaft is placing some angular through the driving shaft. It is the driving shaft axis. This driving shaft axis, the driven shaft should be placing at some an angle. Why we placed this some amount of angle? Any amount of bumps are loads acting on the vehicle, the length of the propeller shaft should be increased. That's why I am placing some angular position of the driven shaft. You can see a simple universal joint. A simple universal joint does not transmit the motion uniformly. So the simple universal joint does not transmit the motion at uniform. So the torque should be not transferred at uniformly. When the shafts are operating at an angle. Why? Because the shafts are acting at different angles. So the diving shaft angle and the driven shaft angle are different. That's why the uniform torque or the uniform power should be transmitted, not transmitted in the vehicle. Because of this, two universal joints are used in a vehicle, one between the other gearbox and the propeller shaft, and the other between the propeller shaft and the differential pinion shaft. So what he told is the universal joint is placed in the one end of the engine output shaft and the another end of the propeller shaft, one end of the propeller shaft and another end of the propeller shaft and the differential input shaft. We are using two universal joints in this automobile vehicle. So it has different types of universal joints, and one of the type is constant velocity joint and sliding joints. There are different types of joints in universal joint. You can see what is the constant velocity joint. It is the constant velocity joints are used to connect your vehicle's transmission to your wheels. These constant velocity joints are part of the drive shaft and are used primarily on front wheel drive vehicles, but they are also used in rear wheel drive and four wheel drive vehicles also. These constant velocity joints are used in the front wheel transmission system. So in this time we will see about the only the rear wheel drive torque transmission system. In this constant by using this constant velocity joints, the torque should be transmitted at front wheel drives. By the torque transmitted at front wheel drives or rear wheel drives or four wheel drive vehicles also. Okay, so in this type of transmission system, these type of constant velocity joints are used to transmit the torque at the automobile vehicles. So it is the diagram of the torque constant velocity joint in the propeller shaft. So in that constant velocity joint, there is a stud axle, that is the driving shaft and the driven shaft. Okay. So in that rubber boot keeps out dirt. So to clean the dirt, we can place a rubber boot on the velocity constant joint and outer socket. It is the outer socket of the velocity constant joint. In this joint, we can place a balls, inner ball race. You can see that inner ball race. We can place the balls. It's very smooth running operation. We are placing this type of balls in the track transmission system. And the splines. And the splines are also placed in the axle shaft. Okay. So these are the different parts in the constant velocity joint. So thank you guys. In further topics, I will tell you in next class. Thank you.